on air. Hello YouTube, welcome to channel 48. My name is Puck. Thank you for tuning in. In this video, I'm gonna teach you how to create a bootable USB stick pen drive that you can use to fix a MacBook or a Mac computer, Intel Mac. Okay, we're gonna do this with a tool called Transmac. However, I'm also gonna show you in this video how to create a bootable DVD from the DMG file that you have on your Windows computer. A DMG file is a Mac image file. In Windows world, it's called ISO. We also have other formats. These are also image files, but the most known are ISO and DMG in Mac world. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna restore a DMG file to a USB stick. There are certain things that you need to know. If you're gonna restore Leopard Snow or Lion or Mountain Lion, you can deal with a USB stick of 8 GB. However, if you want to restore Jasmine or I think El Captain and High Sierra, then you will need a USB stick of at least 16 GB to, you know, to create a good bootable USB stick. All right, so remember that if it's gonna be Lion, Mountain Lion, I think even Mavericks, you can do that on an 8 GB stick. The moment you're gonna try Yosemite or El Captain, or I think it starts with El Captain, or maybe even Yosemite, I'm not even sure because I'm not using those. I'm going up to Mavericks with my devices because that's what I like. It's my personal choice to be on Mavericks and not on Yosemite or El Capitan or High Sierra. My Mac is high enough, trust me. So yeah, I'm just, you know, gonna restore and show you how to restore a Mountain Lion DMG file that you have on your Windows computer. Okay, and of course I'm gonna show you how to create a bootable DVD, a double layer DVD you will need to restore this Mac operating system to the DVD. So remember that double layer, and for Yosemite and higher, you will need a 16 GB USB stick. Are you ready? First thing that you're gonna do, you're gonna go to my description and download Transmac. Transmac is a fantastic tool that will really help you. It helped thousands of people. I have a very popular video how to create a bootable USB pen drive for the repairing of your Mac. Check it out in my list. It's been watched a couple of 100,000 times. Much love the video got. So, but we had also people that, you know, in some way had problems with restoring their Mac. So many people are also asking me, yo, how to do it, how to create a bootable DVD. So that's why, you know, I'm also gonna show that in this video. So if you cannot create some USB stick, if that's not working for you, in most cases the bootable DVD that you're gonna create will work. You will have to put it in, turn the Mac on and hold down the C key, you know, and then it should boot. All right, we also gonna test this USB stick to see if it kind of works what we created. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, and there it is. That is my old Hackintosh, but it's not a Hackintosh anymore. It's a Windows 7 PC because I also need Windows 7 here in my studio. I'm using Mac, Windows and Linux. So what you're gonna do, just open Transmac. Okay, after you installed it, you will have 15 days to use it. I have 14 days left, as you can see, and you must wait some seconds there, and then boom, you can start it. There you go, run. And here you can see the software. Here on top, it's kind of small. It's showing the little USB stick that I popped in. It's saying Lexar GD USB disk and Samsung SSD. That is the internal drive. I'm gonna zoom in for you so you can kind of see it, so you have an idea. So here you can see the stick at the side. Only thing that you will have to do is right mouse click the stick, and you can format it, format disk for Mac. Okay, so you're gonna format the disk for Mac with Transmac, And it's gonna reboot again. You see that?
Okay, Transmac booted back in administrator mode. And as you can see, I'm gonna hit open. And you will see that the formatting was not done yet because my El Capitan installation is still on here. The formatting will only start after you booted the software in administrator mode. Okay, so yeah, what we're now gonna do is we're just gonna format the disk, the USB stick, and we just hit format disk, and here we will have to give permission, so it will be formatted, and then the format will start, and when this is done, the USB stick will be formatted, and then we're gonna restore this USB stick with, of course, the Mac image file, the DMG file of the desired Mac operating system version that we wish. So what we are gonna do is restore with disk image. We just select that one, and I'm gonna go for Mountain Lion this time, and just select it. And go for it. And just give permission and let the process start. At this point, you are creating a bootable USB stick that could boot on a Mac. It's not 100% that it's gonna boot, but it could boot. Alright, so we will not be able to run a second instance of this software, and I'm gonna show that to you, because this is not Winamp. Okay, so it's gonna be one task at a time, and we just let this process go. And in fact, in the next step, I'm gonna show you how to do the same thing, but then to a DVD. And of course, this will be a double layer DVD. So yeah, writing the DVD is kinda easy. There's not so much to it. Only thing you're gonna do is you're gonna go to tools and then burn CD DVD image. You know, just select that, and it will be really easy to then select the image file. I have no burner installed in this laptop, so it won't work. Okay, for me it won't work to burn a DVD on this machine, but for you it will be just easy. Scroll and point to the ISO file, and you will be burning that DVD. Okay, here you can see all the little things that you can set up, etc. Here you see that in fact, yeah, there is no DVD burner, so yeah, there are also some other ways that you could burn, as you could see in there. That's not what we need. Only thing that I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna create a bootable USB stick pen drive with Mountain Lion 8.5 on it, and I'm just gonna see after the restoring if it's gonna boot. We're gonna test that together to see if it all worked, if it's all any good, but I can tell you this is the way how to do it under Windows. It's the best way. Some devices might refuse, but most of the times it's because the people did not format it, the USB stick first to the Mac standard, and in other cases it's because there's not enough space on the USB stick to, for instance, restore Josemit, El Capitan of Mountain Sierra or High Sierra, whatever it's called. So these are the cases. So I'm just gonna let this go, peeps. I'm just gonna let it write the bootable USB stick, and then we're gonna go ahead and take a look if this all will work, and if it's any good, if it can boot on my MacBook Pro 2010. a very nice little laptop that I'm still using on daily basis. And here it is, the stick is done. I'm gonna pop it in, and yeah, I'm gonna put you on the tripod, because yeah, my fingers are not so, I must hold down the option key, the out key, I mean, sorry for that, the out key, the one beside CMD, and then we're gonna boot it. Let's see if it works.
Okay, though, welcome back. As I said, you will have to hold down the out key, and you're gonna press the power on. You hear that? Keep holding the alt key and look at your screen. You see that? This is the disk that we just created, and this one boots just fine on this MacBook Pro 2010. Probably the stick, the 8 GB stick, was not big enough. I think for Justwit and for El Captain and all these others, you will need a greater stick than 8 GB. 8 GB is not enough. Okay, this is Mountain Lion, and Mountain Lion is in size only 4 point something GB. As you can see here, we can start the installing. Everything went right, and it's booting straight from the USB stick. Okay, so I don't need to install this on my MacBook Pro, because my MacBook Pro is running Mavericks, but as you can see, it works just fine. The bootable USB stick, the 10.8 point, what was it, 5 or so, is running just fine. Great work. Now, I sure hope that this helped out, and that you will be able to boot your Mac from the USB, or maybe even the DVD. One more time, you need a double layer DVD to do this, because sizes above 4.5 gigabyte cannot be burned on a normal DVD. I want to thank you for watching. If this helped out, leave this video a like and subscribe to my channel. Link to the software Transmac will be in my description, so go ahead, download it and install it and use it for the coming 15 days and create all the bootable Mac images that you wish on DVD or maybe even on USB stick. To my next video.